Mr. Chairman, His Excellency Mr. Nitin Gadkari, Minister of Road, Transport and Highways of Government of India, Honorable Ministers of the Government of Nepal, His Excellency, Lord PM Lotila, Chairman of Civil Aviation Board of the Philippines, senior officials, prominent business leaders, distinguished dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to be amidst the distinguished gathering today at Infrastructure Summit. I thank the Confederation of Nepalese Industry, CNI, for bringing together key government agencies and the promising private sectors from national and international private sector companies. I would like to extend a warm welcome to you all to Kathmandu, capital city of Nepal. The conference couldn't have been more timely. I'm confident that today's session will come out with detailed and constructive suggestions on policy issues, help build toward network and partnership among the participating entrepreneurs, encourage them to make use of the investment climate and increase the level of much needed investment in Nepal's infrastructure sector. We are greatly pleased and encouraged to have with us His Excellency Mr. Nitin Gadkari, Minister of Road, Transport, Highway and Shipping of the Government of India. His presence at the summit has a special significance. As India is a major source of foreign direct investment as well as biggest trading partner of Nepal, I take this opportunity to appreciate the Government of India for commitment it has shown towards strengthening its connectivity with Nepal as well as across the region. Infrastructure is key to development. Access to quality infrastructure is a prerequisite for reducing poverty, delivering services to people, ensuring a basic standard of living, and accelerating economic growth. A network of adequate infrastructure has a strong linkages between products and markets that create movement of goods and services, transfer of knowledge and skills, and subsequent rise in income and standard of living. Political instability and poor infrastructure together pose two great challenges to investment, environment, and development in Nepal. This, in effect, created other consequent barriers in economic growth. Nepalese society is confronting the problem of unemployment as thousands of youth leave the country every day in search of employment opportunities abroad. The increasing outward flow of people is a worrying trend which not only impacts on economic growth, but also on health, education, and productivity of the country. Nepal plans to graduate from LDC status by 2022. We are in need of massive investment in infrastructure, projects of highways, railways, hydroelectricity, tourism, infrastructure, agro-based industry, and others. We are working to address both policy and structural constraints and challenges to mobilize domestic and foreign capital in the development of much needed infrastructure in the country. I would like to assure that the government is committed to overcome all the difficulties and fulfill gaps to make investment climate further competitive through legal and institutional reforms. Drawing upon the success of South Asian countries and other parts of the developed world, as well as from economic powerhouse, India and China, in the neighborhood, my government is committed to make Nepal as an emerging market destination. We are committed to providing incentives to the foreign investor to expedite cross-border flows of investment, goods and services, and information. Nepal has realized the necessity of economic integration to reduce poverty, achieve long-term economic sustainability, and realize profitable opportunities in hydropower, tourism, agriculture, mining, transportation, infrastructure, and other key areas. Distinguished guests and friends, Nepal is hosting 18 SAARC summit later this month. There are enormous complementaries and commercial potential in the region. The region has a rich demographic profile with the largest concentration of growing middle class. The largest democracy of the world, India, is in the region. The region has become more democratic over the years. The theme selected for the summit is deeper integration for peace and prosperity. We believe that there is close connection between peace and development. Nepal has long advocated for deepening regional integration, development and prosperity of nation, which is only possible in an environment of peace, stability and democratic system of governance. In order to accelerate the process of development in a sustainable manner, we will have to promote fair trade and investment in the region with collective efforts of all its member states. Our region is in dire need of better infrastructure and connectivity. The effort of government alone would not be sufficient to bridge the gap. The private sector must take initiatives with large-scale investment and technologies and play active role in developing infrastructure. Ladies and gentlemen, Nepal is in the midst of historic democratic transformation. We are working to have a democratic constitution promulgated through the elected Constituent Assembly. There is a political consensus on the need to further institutionalize liberal trade policies and make legislative reform to create an environment conducive to the welcoming private investment. There has been an institutionalization of high-level body to fast-track mega projects in order to achieve our economic priorities of long-term economic sustainability. Delivery of robust infrastructure and poverty alleviation. We are committed to further strengthening institutions dedicated to those areas. Nepal is blessed with immense natural and human resources. Our national strength is unique, unity in vast diversity. Nepal is a seat of ancient civilization, offering some of the world's great cultural heritage sites, including Lumbini, the birthplace of Lord Buddha. To this country of natural beauty and abundance of resources, we have democracy that brings the people at the center of governance. We consider people as vital resource for development. We have seen countries developing by leaps and bounds because of decades of investment in their people. Our major development challenge today is to retain the dynamic and hard-working people in the country by providing them economic opportunities, which I believe will be generated through massive investment in infrastructure. We recall with pleasure the visit of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in Nepal last August. It was a satisfying visit. The recent signing of PPA, Power Trade Agreement with India, and PDA, Power Development Agreement with GMR Group, had opened the door for private and foreign investment in Nepal. The market for energy is not only Nepal and India, but the entire South Asian region. We are encouraged that the World Bank has indicated its willingness to inject $5 billion within the next few years for Nepal's hydropower development. We need to build on the work that has been done over the years with peace established in the country. My government is fully committed to create all necessary policy framework to allow accelerated infrastructure growth and development. We have high-level investment board Nepal, IBN, chaired by Prime Minister, that provides one window service and investment proposal in timely manner. Through a drastically reduced time for FDI approval, we have sent a strong signal regarding our commitment to creating a supportive environment for large-scale investment. Furthermore, agreements we have in place, such as bilateral investment promotion and protection agreement, BIPA, and double taxation avoidance agreement, DTAA, with various countries, indicate the level of seriousness from our part in terms of policy initiatives. Nepal hosts the clear characteristics of an attractive investment destination, strategic location between two emerging economic powers with young, talented, and hardworking population. Doing Business Index of the World, World Bank ranked Nepal higher than that of several popular investment destinations. It has been well documented that Nepal has the potential to generate 83,000 megawatts of electricity, out of which not even 1% is being produced. And we have to live in load shedding. In addition to hydropower, there are opportunities to invest in tourism and obtain tallest peak in the world lie in Nepal, providing a golden opportunity in adventure tourism. Being the birthplace of Lord Buddha and other symbolic aspects, there is an opportunity in religious tourism. Furthermore, there is arable land, a great climate, and a possibility of diverse hubs waiting for investment. There is an opportunity in manufacturing industry, not only to meet the growing demand of the rising middle class in Nepal, but also to export to growing economies in the region. I hope this summit will play a crucial role in encouraging foreign government and entrepreneurs to make use of investment opportunities available in Nepal. I wish all the participants a pleasant stay and a very successful, productive summit. The government of Nepal looks forward to working together with the governments and private entrepreneurs to develop an enhanced level of connectivity, welcome investment and technologies at a greater level, and further expanding the sphere of bilateral trade. If you are looking for investment opportunities for the next decade, for the next generation, for the 21st century, Nepal is the strategic entry point. Welcome to Nepal. Thank you. Jai Nepal.